Hello students, today we will discuss in chapter 2 for class 12, that is electrostatic potential and capacitance. So before starting it, just recall what we learned in chapter 1. So basically what we learned in chapter 1, we learn electric charge and its properties. After that we study electrostatic force between two charges, then electric field line, electric dipole, then Gauss's theorem and the application of Gauss's theorem for finding electric field for various configuration. So basically in this chapter we will learn two physical quantities, that is one electric field and another one is electric force. So when a charge is placed at a point, it makes an electric field region surrounding it, and whenever a charge is placed in this region of electric field, they exert an electrostatic force. This is all about chapter 1. Now, in this chapter, we will study another two physical quantities, that is electric potential and another one is electric potential difference. Then capacitance, and there is a combination of capacitance. So, let's start. So, what is electric potential difference? So what is electric potential difference? Suppose we consider a positive charge placed at origin O. So then it will make an electric field region surrounding it. And in this electric field region, we consider two points A and B. And take a unit positive charge placed at point A. Then this positive charge taken from A to B. So replacing this positive charge from A to B, what we have to do? We have to do work done by an external agency. So work done from A to B have to be done. Then electric potential difference VA minus VV can be written as W A to B divided by this test charge. Clear? Why VA minus VV? We have to take final point first, then the initial point. Here, charge is taken from A to B. So, A is the initial point and B is the final point. That's why VA minus VB. If we take the positive charge from B to A, then it will be VA minus VB. So, what is potential difference? Potential difference between two points in an electric field may be defined as amount of work done taking a unit moving unit positive charge from one point to another point in against the electrostatic force. Why in against electrostatic force? Just check it. Here is charge plus Q. Here Q naught, that is also positive. So this one is positive, this one is positive. The nature of force is repulsive and the direction is along x-axis. And we have to take a test charge from A to B, that is the direction is that side. So force is directed along x-axis, and we have taken this charge against this electrostatic force. So basically, what is electric potential difference? Electric potential difference is defined as the amount of work done from A to B, taken another one point to another point, per unit positive charge. Clear? Then what will be the unit of this amount of work done? That is unit joule, and for charge, that is coulomb. So, joule per coulomb, that is volt. Suppose you have to define 1 volt potential difference. So, what will be the definition? 1 volt potential difference between two points has to be done when 1 joule work is done in moving a positive 1 coulomb charge from point A to B against the electrostatic force. Okay. Then, next question is, what is electric potential? So, what is electric potential? Here, you consider the point A lies at infinity. So, this expression will be VB minus V infinity, that is equal to W infinity to B divided by Q naught. Okay. Now, here one assumption is given, that is electric potential at a point far away from a point charge. Far away from a point charge as taken as 0. That is, at infinity, the electric potential value is 0. That is the assumption. Then, it can be written as Vb minus 0, that is equal to W divided by Q naught. So, Vb is equal to W divided by Q naught. Here, Vb represent electric potential at point B. The expression is same, that is amount of work done divided by test charge. So, what is the definition of electric potential? The definition of electric potential in electric field is defined as the amount of work done, the amount of work done in taking a unit positive charge from infinity to that point. Infinity, one reference point, and that point where we have to calculate electric potential. Clear? Here unit is also same, that is joule per coulomb, so that is volt. Now question same, that is define 1 volt electric potential. What will be the definition? There is 1 volt electric potential said to be done when 1 joule work has to be done, when 1 joule work has to be done by taking a 1 coulomb of charge from infinity to that point. So this is the definition of 1 volt electric potential. Now what is the dimension? All of you know that is formula is W by Q naught, amount of work done, M L square T minus 2, and for charge that is AT. So the dimension will be M L square T to the power minus 3, A to the power minus 1. So this is all about electric potential and electric potential difference. তাহলে আমরা কি বললাম? Electric potential যখন আমরা define করব, তখন আমাদের একটা reference point হচ্ছে infinity, আর একটা point হচ্ছে আমরা যে pointে calculate করতে চাইছি। আর potential difference টা কি? Potential difference হচ্ছে দুটো pointের মধ্যে, যে pointের মধ্যে, যে point দুটোর মধ্যে আমরা difference টা বার করতে চাইছি, সেই point দুটোর মধ্যে একটা charge কে আনতে গেলে আমাদের যে amount of work done করতে হচ্ছে divided by যে amount of charge টাকে নিয়ে আসছি। এখানে একটা পয়েন্ট মাথায় রাখতে হবে, এই যে চার্জটাকে আমরা নিয়ে আসছি, এই চার্জের ভ্যালুটা ইনফাইনাইটলি স্মল হতে হবে, কারণ এই চার্জটা যাতে এই ইলেকট্রিক ফিল্ডে কোনো ইনফ্লুয়েন্স না রাখে। ক্লিয়ার? সো দ্যাট ইজ ইলেকট্রিক পোটেনশিয়াল এন্ড ইলেকট্রিক পোটেনশিয়াল ডিফারেন্স। নেক্সট উই হ্যাভ টু ক্যালকুলেট ইলেকট্রিক পোটেনশিয়াল ডিউ টু এ পয়েন্ট চার্জ। ইন চ্যাপ্টার 1 উই ক্যালকুলেট ইলেকট্রিক পোটেনশিয়াল, সরি ইলেকট্রিক ফিল্ড ডিউ টু এ পয়েন্ট চার্জ। Now we have to calculate electric potential due to a point charge. Consider a charge plus Q placed at origin O. Here we have to calculate electric potential at point P, which is separated at a distance r from origin O. Now just consider here two point A and B. This is infinity. Take a unit positive charge at point A. So there is charge Q, and at point A there is considered a unit positive charge, that is Q naught. And the separation between O to A, suppose X. So what will be the force between them? The electrostatic force between Q and Q naught, F will be formula same, that is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught product of charges divided by the separation square, that is separation x. So this one will be x square. This is the electrostatic force between Q and Q naught. Now suppose we have to taken a charge Q naught from A to B. This separation, small separation, that is dx. So we have to done work done by an external agency. Then amount of work done, right? The amount of work done in bringing a charge Q naught from A to B formula will be dw that is equal to f vector dot dx vector. Work done, force into displacement. Just check here one thing, here dx directed along negative x axis, and the direction of force, this is positive, this is positive, repulsive, so the direction of force is along positive x axis. So this work done against this electrostatic force, so the direction dx and f just opposite, that is angle is 180. So this expression will be f dx cos 180, and the value of cos 180, that is minus 1. So dw will be f dx minus of f dx. Clear? So this is the amount of work done in bringing a unit positive charge from A to B. Now we have to calculate the total amount of work done, and this amount of work done where point, if reference points where infinity to point P. So write it, the total amount of work done, the total amount of work done, total work done in bringing a charge from infinity to point P, W will be integration of dW. Clear? Integration limit will be infinity to P, that is P point is, position is R, that is infinity to R. Now putting the value of dW, that is infinity to R, dW means minus F into dx. Clear? Now putting the value of x, infinity to R minus 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q q naught by x square into dx. Here constant term will be outside of this integration, so this one will be minus q q naught by 4 pi epsilon naught outside, and integration infinity to R x to the power minus 2 into dx. This x square in upper side, this one will be x to the power minus 2. Now W equal to minus q q naught divided by 4 pi epsilon naught. This integration result will be x to the power minus 1 minus 2 plus 1 divided by minus 2 plus 1, and the limit is same, that is infinity to R, that is minus q q naught by 4 pi epsilon naught. There is minus 2 plus 1, that's minus 1. This minus 1 and this minus 1, this one will be plus 1. Okay. And this expression x to the power minus 2 plus 1, that is x to the power minus 1. In lower side, this one will be 1 by x infinity to R. Just putting the limit, that is q q naught by 4 pi epsilon naught, upper limit, that is 1 by R, minus of lower limit, that is 1 by infinity. Okay. And we know 1 by infinity, that is 0. So amount of work done W from bringing a charge from infinity to point P, and the result is q q naught by 4 pi epsilon naught 1 by R. Okay, just write q q naught here, q q naught by R. So this is the total amount of work done. Now question is, we have to calculate electric potential, and the formula is, electric potential formula is, formula is V, that is equal to W by Q naught, that is amount of work done divided by test charge. So what will be the value? Work done value 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q Q naught by R, and there is Q naught. So Q naught cancel out. The value of V, that is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R. Clear? So this is the final expression of electric potential due to a point charge. Eta khyal koro, amra ekta point charge jonno electric field er result ki peyechhilam. Electric field due to a point charge, that is formula 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R square. And here electric potential due to a point charge formula is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r square. So here electric field inversely proportional to the square of the separation, and electric potential is inversely proportional to just the separation. If we draw a graph, electric field and electric potential with distance, the graph will be, suppose along x-axis this is r, and along y-axis E and V. Okay, so one graph will be like this, another one will be like this. So this one will be obviously this one, because this one is inversely proportional to 1 by r square. Okay, so that is E proportional to 1 by r square, and this one will be V, that is proportional to 1 by r. So this is the diagram, electric field and electric potential with distance. Okay, now we have to calculate electric potential due to a number of point charges. Electric potential due to a number of point charges. এবং এটা ক্যালকুলেট করার জন্য আমরা কি জানি, আমাদের যেটা দরকার সুপারপজিশন প্রিন্সিপাল। মানে সুপারপজিশন প্রিন্সিপাল কি? সুপারপজিশন প্রিন্সিপাল স্টেটমেন্ট হচ্ছে টোটাল ইলেকট্রিক পটেনশিয়াল হবে ইন্ডিভিজুয়াল যে পটেনশিয়াল সেগুলোর সামেশন। ওকে, ওয়ান পয়েন্ট ইজ হিয়ার, দ্যাট ইজ ইলেকট্রিক পটেনশিয়াল ইজ এ স্কেলার কোয়ান্টিটি, দ্যাট ইজ দ্য অ্যাডভান্টেজ। ইন চ্যাপ্টার 1 ইলেকট্রিক ফিল্ড ইজ এ ভেক্টর কোয়ান্টিটি, সো অলওয়েজ উই হ্যাভ টু ফাইন্ড আউট দ্য ডিরেকশন। হিয়ার ইলেকট্রিক পটেনশিয়াল ইজ এ স্কেলার কোয়ান্টিটি, সো উই ডোন্ট নিড টু ফাইন্ড আউট ইটস ডিরেকশন। ক্লিয়ার? সো suppose there is charge q1, there is q2, there is q3, there is up to ...qn, and from origin q1 position vector r1, from q2 position vector r2, from q3 position vector r3, similarly for qn position vector rn, and we have to find out the potential at point P here, net electric potential. So at first you have to find out electric potential for Q1 at point P, then electric potential at point P for Q2, similarly for Q3, then similarly up to for Qn. So what will be the electric potential at point P for Q1? That is V1 is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught amount of charge Q1 divided by the separation, that is R1. Similarly, V2, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q2 by R2. Similarly, for a number of charges, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Qn by Rn. Clear? Then, what will be the net electric field? According to superposition principle, the net electric field E will be, net electric potential, not electric field, net electric potential V will be addition, that is summation of V1 plus V2 up to Vn. Just putting the individual value here, common side is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, that is Q1 by R1 plus Q2 by R2 plus up to Qn by Rn. Now simplify it using summation. In the summation, one index I, that is 1 to n, that is Qi by Ri. So this is the expression of electric potential for n number of point charges. Index given 1 to n. If we take index I equal to 1, then this one will be Q1 by R1. If we take 2, so this one will be Q2 by R2, and index is given 1 to n, so this one is Q1 by R1 plus Q2 by R2 plus dot 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 up to Qn by Rn. So this is the final expression for n number of point charges, that is electric potential. Now one thing here, suppose we have to consider continuous charge distribution, and for continuous charge distribution, the electric potential formula dV or V formula will be, looks like 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught integration dQ by R. Here for volume charge distribution, it will be 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught integration for volume for volume charge density, rho equal to, we know that dq by dv. So dq equal to rho into dv, that is rho dv by r. For surface side density, it will be vs, that is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. For surface side density, sigma equal to, we know, dq by ds. So this one will be sigma ds by r, integration over surface. And for line charge density, this one will be vl equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, integration over l, lambda dl divided by r. Because for line charge density, lambda equal to dq by dl. And what is the total electric field? The summation of v, v, vs and vl. And for general charge distribution, we have to take this one plus the summation of these three potential. Okay. So this is all about today class. And in this class, we learn that is electric potential difference. After that, we calculate electric potential due to a point charge, electric potential due to a number of point charge, and electric potential with concept of continuous charge distribution. Okay. So this class is ending here. Thank you. Stay tuned.